Dear students, we are going to continue the module 1. In this module, we are going to discuss about the assembler algorithms. So there are two paths of assembler algorithm, path 1 algorithm and path 2 algorithm. As we know that path 1 algorithm, assembler path 1, it generates the location address of the program, and path 2, it generates the object code and object program. So let us start with path 1 algorithm. So path 1, the first point is we will write the begin, then read first input line. And if opcode is equal to start, if operation code is equal to start, then begin save operand as a starting address. Then operand value corresponding to the start will be considered as starting address, and initialize the location counter to starting address, and we should initialize the location counter with the starting address. As in our program, as we saw that starting address is 1000, so 1000 is the location starting location address, and write the line in intermediate file. We should also write in path 1, it will also write in the intermediate file which will be processed by path 2 algorithm. Then read next input line. Then we should read the next input line and if till the end of the start. If opcode is not equal to start, then we should initialize the location counter with zero value. Now next we should process some operation with this person till we reach the opcode equal to end. While opcode is not equal to end, we should keep on processing this begin. If this is not a comment line, then if next instruction, if this is not a comment line, then begin. If there is a symbol in label field, then in the label field, as we know that first it will be symbol, then opcode, and then operand. So if there is symbol in label field, then begin search symbol table for label. We should search the symbol table for the corresponding label. If found, then set error flag, means it is duplicate. So means more than one label should not be there in the symbol table. If it is found, then it is a duplicate symbol. Else insert label location counter into the symbol table. If this is not true, then we should insert label and location counter of that corresponding label into the symbol table. End if symbol. Then we should end the if symbol. Search operation table for the operation code. Then next we should search the operation table for the opcode. If found, then add 3. If found, then add 3 to the location counter. Instruction length of location counter is 3. Else if opcode is not equal is equal to word, here the assembler directive. If opcode is equal to word, then add 3 to location counter. If opcode equal to reserved word, then we should add 3 into number of operand to the location counter. Else if opcode equal to reserved byte, then we should add number of operands to the location counter, because each operand is of 1 byte, it reserves 1 byte in the data area. then we should add number of operand to the location. Else if opcode is equal to byte, then begin find length of constant in bytes and length to location counter. Then we should find the length of constant in bytes and add length of location counter. Then end if byte. Else set error flag invalid operation code. End if not comment. Write line to the intermediate. After that we should write the whole line to the intermediate byte and we should read the next input line. And here while loop it is getting finished. Next step, we should write the last line to the intermediate file, which will be processed by the class 2 algorithm, and save location counter with starting address as program length and pass 1. So this is how the pass 1 algorithm will end. Next is pass 2 algorithm. In pass 2 algorithm, we know that it generates the object code of the operand of the program, and it also generates the object program. So let us see. So read first input line from the intermediate file. As we know that intermediate file generated by pass 1 algorithm will be processed by pass 2 algorithm. So we should read the first line of the intermediate file. If opcode equal to start, then begin write listing line, read the next input line, end if start. Write the listing line, read next input line, and end if start. Write header record to object program, initialize first text record. We should write the header record. Okay, so as we know that there are three records in the object program, header, text, and end. So if this is the case, then we should write a header record to the object program and initialize the first text record. Now while opcode equal to not end, till this one it will be keep going on. Now begin, this is not a comment line. Then begin set operation table for the opcode. We found then begin, there is a symbol in operand file, then search symbol table for the operand. If found, then symbol value as operand address. Else begin store 0 as the operand address. Then set error flag. End. End if symbol. Else store 0 as, after this ending, this if means. Else store 0 as operand address. If there is no operand, then we should store 0 as operand address. Then assemble the object code instruction. Then we should also assemble the object code instruction. End if opcode found. So end if opcode found. Else if opcode equal to byte. Suppose some assembler directives are there. If opcode equal to byte or word, then convert the constant to object code. Then we should convert the corresponding constant with byte or word to the object code. If object code will not fit into the current text record, as we saw in the our object program, because only 10 instruction you can write in one line. So if more than 10 instructions are there in the program, then it will not fit in one current text record. If not, then begin write text record to object program. Then we should write another text record to the object program. Then initialize new text record and end. Add object code to text record and if not comment. Write listing line, read next input line. End file not end.